Hi there, content creators. Welcome to the VSDC channel. In today's video, we will show you how to make a trace path effect and create a smoke trail behind an airplane using VSDC. We will explore applying a motion tracking tool, working with distortions, and using masks. So let's get started. First, we add a video of an airplane to our project. The key here is to accurately track the airplane's trajectory. And for this, we will create a movement map. To do this, right-click on the video on the timeline and select Create Movement Map. You'll be prompted to choose a path for saving the map on your computer. As soon as you complete this, a window for creating the map will emerge. Move to the 2-second mark on the timeline when the airplane appears in the frame. Adjust the frame to fit the size of the airplane and click Analyze Forward. Done. Next, rewind back to the 2-second mark and click Analyze Backward to track the airplane back to the beginning of the video. After that, click Apply Editing and save the map. Now it's time to utilize the motion map we've just created. Draw an ellipse so that the airplane fits within it. This ellipse will later serve as a mask. Now we need to add our movement map. Double-click on the ellipse on the timeline and go to the Editor tab. Select Add Object, Movement, Movement Map. A quick note here. If this option is disabled, you might still be on scene 0, where effects cannot be added. Make sure you are inside the ellipse. Going back to adding the map, we select from start of the scene for it to appear simultaneously with the object. After that, let's move the map so the ellipse covers the airplane. And like magic, the ellipse follows the airplane. Then return to scene 0. Our next step is to draw a trajectory for the path. For this, we need to take a screenshot. Select the ellipse so that the trajectory is visible. Then use the Windows Shift S shortcut and select the scene to capture. Paste the screenshot, extend its duration, and use the curve line tool to draw the airplane's path. After that, make the screenshot invisible. Now it's animation time. Select the line that you've drawn, go to its properties, and find the visible length parameter. Click the three dots on the right to open the key editor. The default window size might be small, so feel free to enlarge it or to switch to a different interface configuration. We will switch to the parameters by clicking the square icon at the top. Excellent! Now we are ready to add keyframes. Switch to the Bezier curve mode. Add and fine-tune keyframes so that the line's end is within the ellipse. Keyframes can be conveniently added with the Insert key and adjusted with the Shift key held down to move the key along a single axis. Great! Now it's time to make the ellipse a mask. Head back to scene 0, copy the ellipse and paste it inside the curve. Then navigate to the ellipse properties, make the pen fill transparent and change the brush color to black. Then on the timeline layer, change the blending mode to mask. Perfect! Now the ellipse cuts the line. But let's make the mask edge a bit smoother. Enter the ellipse and add a blur effect the following way. Video Effects, Filters, Gaussian Blur. And set the blur level to 15. Going back to scene 0, we will apply a distortion effect to the curve. Proceed to the Editor tab, then Video Effects, Transforms, Distort. In the effects properties, select type explode and set the shift size to 30. And finally, let's make our smoke trail gracefully vanish over time. On scene 0, select the curve and convert it to a sprite. Change the sprite settings to Uses container? No. Show effects? Yes. Brush? Transparent. Then go inside the sprite. Zoom out and draw a rectangle about twice the size of the scene. In its properties, select Brush Type Gradient to create a black and white gradient. Click the Show Gradient Vector button. Now, move the vector ends on the scene so that the bottom left corner is white and the top right corner is black. Change the blending mode to Inverted Mask and animate it. For this, go inside the rectangle, click Add Movement, and add a point above the top right corner so that the mask exits the scene area. Move the cursor on the timeline around the first second. You'll see that our smoke trail gradually fades over time. Feel free to experiment by adding more distortion effects or coloring the curved line to achieve your unique vision. And that's it! If you find this video helpful, do not forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. See you next time!